Okay. Yes, see. Trying to get your stupid Obi wrap before you have. But save you some time. Destroy the competition, you think? Just use that admin command. Destroy all tribe structures. Just gonna check this lot of breeding and then we'll duck over to Lost. Let's spawn a couple of gods in. Ooh, we got a prime. Yeah, I can see the chat. That's full stat. Not full stat. Don't really care about weight. Wish I told you what they were. Some of them do, some of them don't. It's really weird. I'm trying to cross the mutation, not mutation, so the, you know, alpha, beta, etc. You get random. Some tell you what level they are and others don't. That is an alpha. That is a beta. Beta. Another beta. That's a prime. That's an alpha. Beta. Beta. Alpha. It's a Deinonychus. So we got one prime. What's that, buddy? Yep. I reckon. I got rid of all your halves and stuff. We've only got breeding now. Put you up, about to get this one up. Alright, we got that one. You're alright, mate. No props. Okay, gender swap that one to a female. I don't even know what this thing does, but sure. Grow up. BB. Alright, the rest of this. Junk we'll get rid of. Start from scratch. Just two. Back to just two. But it'll be, it's going to be easier. Oh. At least now we're like only one level apart, so that's going to make it better and the stats should be closer. Is it hungry? No. Amazes me how much these eggs, how much food they give me. It's out of control. Just hit this button a few times and then we'll start flying around and forget what they move. before the reindeer. But they're better than the reindeers. No way. Come on. What's this little thing here? Do we have a saddle for it? I'm assuming we must. Otherwise, why are we breeding it? Finished. We have a saddle, right? Hope you have a saddle. Ozzy Dan Dan. How are you, big fella? Ovi. That helped. Wow, this could take 100 years. We have a lot of unique saddles, by the way. Gents, like, a lot. It's PT... Oviraptor. Okay. Head replaced with an egg. Sweet. 1,000% attack radius with Breedian variant. Nice. 2,000% melee damage with Breedian variant. 2,000%? Okay. 95% damage reduction with breeding variant. 25% reduced cooldown without breeding variant. Whatever that means. 400% ability damage without breeding variant. 75% dodge chance without breeding variant. Okay, so 2,000% melee and 95% damage reduction. It's not a bad saddle. Not gonna lie. That's a good saddle. What's going on, Mr. Dan? How was your day, sir? It's got hot here again this afternoon. I just put the AC on. Just put the AC on to cool this joint down, because it's getting a little hot down here in the computer room. Probably turn some of the computers off would probably help, but it seems like a problem. Just going to hit breed on these guys a couple of times and then... Yeah, I turned those on about 5 minutes ago too. It's just got sticky down. It's just like, I was sitting there, I'm like, it's just getting a bit, ugh. It's not too hot, but it wasn't pleasant either. These better be good, Z. You're making me breed again after I spent all weekend breeding. Bases. I don't think there's anything on rag at all. I mean, this is our base. It's very pretty. Look at it. It's magnificent. It is function over form. It's designed purely for storing things and breeding. It's not pretty, but it is very functional. Can one of you gents just check that Discord link's still active? I'm pretty sure I updated it. JPH, that should be the new one, I'm pretty sure. Why have I got that? I don't want that, that's supposed to be in there. One more hit of the button and then we'll go over to Lost, and then there's a couple of bases over in Lost we'll have a look at. Over to Forgeor, and then we'll switch clusters. Most of the... There's a lot of really nice bases on the other... Yeah, PvE cluster. Some lovely people have offered to open their door for me, so that was very nice of them. Very nice community we've got. Alright, let's go to Lost. Half these bases we're not going to be able to get into. This is going to be a fly around, have a look. Some of them will have shields. Great community, exactly, yeah. Yep, yeah, I got a message from Odara before, you know, she's like, yes, here's my coordinates, beautiful. And then, you know, do you want me to unlock the door? Oh, that'd be great if you don't mind. No worries, help yourself. Perfect, I mean, you can't ask for more, can you? Purple in, and the boat. All right, well, the stinking boat. What boat? It's not a boat, is it? It's a shipwreck. Boats, you know, move. Shipwrecks don't, but sure. All right, here's Zit's shipwreck. It's actually really cool. One shipwreck. That is your galleon, is it? All right. Well, I mean, it is actually very cool. I do like how you do your boats. I kind of wish that you build them on a raft so we could move around on them, but it is very well done. Like, your sails look amazing. It's definitely got a hole in the bottom. You're going to need a bilge pump in here. You can't even get out there. Wow. I'm stuck in here now. Better climb the ladder. Now I do like your ship, so I am. I just wish that they moved. All right, what else have we got on Lost, gents? I know there's one over here. We'll go to the one over near the Black Pearl Lake. Oh, I know where, oh yeah, Aussie Dance place is there, and there's another place just around the corner from here as well. Escape's place is just up the beach a bit, isn't it? Same stretch of beach. The neighbours, practically. Not in vain, we're just saying that we're going to check out your build. Ooh. Oh, you're a low level, aren't we? I don't want to. That only that was like an Omega or something, we'd be taming that. We had to go and have a look at your base, Dan. So. What about a Bronchosaurus? They're pretty cool. I like those guys. Anky tail crossed with a Brontosaurus. Not bad. I'm on Omega at the moment, but I'll be switching to PvE after I've done the three Omega servers. Has anybody built anything in the castle? Let's have a look. Not sure this would be a great place in Omega, to be honest. Probably a little bit psychopathic, to be honest. It was bad enough on normal PvE. Spicy. Sort of. Not really. Not really a base. We'll check both. You've got a place on Lost on PvE as well, don't you? Top of the hill. Up near the waterfall there. Where am I going? That way, this way. Oh yeah, well we're only halfway through. Everybody's going to be in progress. Everybody will be in progress. So this is the one I was going to show you here. We can't get in, obviously, because the shield's not going to let me. I really love what they've done with the wall. The wall looks fantastic. Come on. Yeah, it's just fly away from that, mate. I reckon the wall looks fantastic in this thing. Like, such good use of the contours of the ground, and the nice little sort of castle-y strip, compound fort build inside. Not bad at all. And we've got breeding area down there. I'm guessing doing maybe water donors could be. Just excuse my voice, guys. I'm still struggling with this cold. I don't know how long I'm going to talk for, but we'll see. So, yeah, I like that one. I thought that was quite good. The staircase is around. I like that having the staircase on around the top of the books gives it a really good effect. And all the handrails, they've done a really good job. So that's Persky AU. So yeah, good build. Obviously on Amiga, no mods, so to speak. Dan, is your teleport on public? Mistaken, sir. So. Well, hopefully that's not inside, or we're going to be in trouble with the wyvern. So here's Forsaken's, another stone building into the side of the thing. We have had a brief look in there. I think Zit did a walkthrough briefly a couple of days ago, maybe. Quite a lot of room in there. It's a lot bigger than it looks. And then young Dan's base, he should be down here. A good spot you gents live in too. Nice and peaceful around here. See a Dan Aussie Flight Center. Should kill that. That's the opposition. We don't want any Flight Center. Giant horse, Dan. That is a giant horse. Hey, the base is looking good, Dan. I haven't seen your base for a while. It's come a long way. You got some Rexes, Stego. You've been busy. You have been busy. Sheep in there. Let's see, did he leave the door unlocked? He did. Thanks, Dan. You can check out your base now. Sleeping, it's a tired little fella. Worn himself out.
What you think about when you're born into a
fire? Very nice, Dan. You need like you get Zit to build you a boat out here. It won't go anywhere, but it'll look cool at the end of the dock. Isn't there a base further around here? I think there was. I'm probably going to miss some bases because I don't have coordinates for everybody's base, and yeah, I think people may be keeping their cards a bit close to their chest. Wasn't there a base at the end of this little bay thing here or something? Maybe I was wrong. Actually, maybe that was mistaken and they moved. Yeah, I don't know. I can't remember. There was a base here, pretty certain. Up on the hill on the right. Up like up above your, near the crystal. like above your base, Dan, or like over behind the blue orb where the crystal net is? Okay, I'll have a little. I'll have a little gander. See if we can find something. Yeah, there's sort of bases here and everywhere. Someone's got some foundations there, but no base. Not sure what that's about. Oh, saddle. What is it? What is it? Patchy saddle. Damn it. Still, saddle's a saddle. Already got a few of those, but... What's this? Start of a pretty cool looking base. Who's this for? A big chief. Big chief hasn't been on for quite some time because it's demolishable. Alright, well. I will just screenshot that and add it to my need to be deleted list. Alright, Dan. Cheers, mate. Thanks for dropping by. Appreciate it, mate. Yeah, see you tonight for a bit of The Forest, or Sons of the Forest, or whatever cuckoo game it is we're playing tonight. Ooh, what's this base? That was a big one. Alright, this looks small. This looks like a bit of an active base at least. I got staff inside. Dodo killers. Not sure who they are, but I like what they've done though. They haven't been on for a while either, because they're a day away from being demolished. Gonna do a tidy up, I think. Interesting that people built a lot of buildings over this side of the map. Maybe it's the easy spawn, I don't know. I'm not sure, to be honest, where the easy spawn even is on this map. I thought it was actually down near the... So anyway, let's shoot across to... Excuse me, for your door. One button. Want that one. Come on, we're back to our little humble abode over here, which is not really anything other than a shipwreck. Anything new is there? No. Alright, let's go to Forge. Quickly go to Forge, then I'll go back to Rag, and then I'll swap over to the PvE cluster, which is where most of the builds are. There's not that many builds on them. Of the Omega, most people don't bother. It's only a few dedicated souls. They want to risk their base getting destroyed. Let's wait for this to load in. This is the Purple Palace, I believe, is where we are at. It's all been painted purple. Someone had far too much time on their hands. Looks quite good, actually. Came out quite well. What is even up here? Does anyone even know? You need a diving board. You need a diving board into the pool. That's what you need. See, that would have been heaps better with a diving board. Right, let's just yeet off the side. There we go. Some crop plots. So we've got a bit of a farm going there. A nice little bar. Some of this RR Deco stuff's actually pretty good. I haven't actually played with any of it yet, but it looks quite... it's nice for a change. Like, it's nice and modern, which is very different to most of the mods. Quite an interesting build. Taxidermy base. What does that look like? RR Tech Deco map. Oh, that's cool. Wow. I mean, it's not... It's the island, I think, isn't it? Yeah, that's the island. It's cool. That's actually the island. That's not Forgel. Can you change that? Is that what that does? Oh no, that just changes that. Oop, my bad. Uh oh. I think that's what he's doing. Can you change the map? Doesn't look like it. Hold for options. No. Yeah, they do some cool stuff. That's awesome. I like that. Okay. Come here, Wavin. Let's go, buddy. All right, where are we? We want to go that way, maybe. I don't know. I'll know when I get out of these trees. Yeah, there. Right there. No, one of the lovely Patreons to support the server is currently building in here. I don't believe that she has finished. I think it's a work in progress. And I think she's away at the moment, I believe. She certainly... What's going on? I'm pretty sure that she's away. Looks... Wow. Looking good. Destroy it, please. No, I'm not destroying that. It's too nice. No, it's beautiful. Looks like... Oh, look at the cool greenhouse at the back. That's a good idea. What a great idea that is. Good. Really good lines, too. The whole thing looks like it's supposed to be there. So, yeah, mega fairy mum. Really, yeah. Fairly new member to the server in the last month, 6 weeks, maybe something like that. And yeah, really cool. Chatty in game, chatty in the Discord. Just a very, very lovely, cool lady who clearly can build. Tell you what, it could be, that's early progress. Imagine what that's going to look like in 2 weeks' time with a bit more work on it. Might have to up our game. Beautiful build. Looks like it's meant to be there. What is the deal with lots of wyverns on Forgel over there? Okay, where am I going? Purple something, wasn't it? Purple inn we've been to. Linda's Mushroom. Yeah, I think we got our work cut out for us there. Whoa. Uh-oh. Mistakes have been made, dude. I need to pick up the wire, hang on. Alright, where are we here? Some trippy... Oh, here we are. Alright, yeah, right, we're in this place. I know where we are. Already got that one, I think. Yep. I'm stuck in a hole. Ah, the old stack drop lights. I like it. So this thing's supposed to... Unstable water. Oh, she's, I'm just doing it old school. She's using that and that rather than the salt terminal. Alright, respect. This must be where the good stuff is, right? It's just a beautiful build, isn't it? Metal Desi. What's up here? But it's like an obstacle course. Oh, this is the breeding boxes. I get it. It's the magical breeding boxes. Omega Element Trilobite. Wow, they're trippy. Cool. I wonder if this is a breeding. Is this a breeding project? Does anyone know? If this is something that we're going to breed? Or we're just collecting element? There's a lot of element in there. Holy moly. Four potion sinos. Sacrificial. Alright, what's up here? There's probably stairs, but let's just cheat. Oh, now we're in trouble. Oh, what are we? Oh, we found the tech gen. It's dark in here. What does that connect up to? I feel like you almost need a tour. You need everyone to be on to take you for a tour and explain their base. It would make it a lot more enjoyable. But still, it's only early dawn, so. It's good to have a little check it out, see what's going on. Been up there. Is there anything I'm missing here? What, great location. Can't believe how deep that water is. Alright. Is there anything else on Forge World that I should look at? See, you spend time over here. I never come over here. I'm too busy breeding. So, is there anything else on Forge World that I should look at while I'm here? There are only three. I think that's on the video faster. That's on, pretty sure that that is on 896. Yes. Hey, let's have a look. We've got a couple of you that are on. Let's check them out. Linda's mushroom is superb. Yes, loving it, loving it. Right, we've got it. Aidsville. Just check out the public, the ones that are on public, so we can. They kind of left the door open for us, so that's good, right? Sleeping. I did pick up it. Alright, location's good. Nice view. A bit of vault in the background. Okay. Still a bit of work to go. The stairs, that's a problem. Whoa. There we go. Made it. Wood Argy. Alright, so early. They're early game. They're early on. How long have they been on? Oh, I got that. They were on yesterday or the day before, so that's good. They might be new, actually. Yeah, pretty new. Pretty new. Alright, let's see what other TPs we got that are on public that could be worthwhile having a look at. Rage God is leaving this world. Someone didn't kill the Rage God. That's not good. LZ20. Oh, that's one of ours. Don't worry about that. Spoiled bosses. No, we don't want that. Awesome teleporter. Go that one. Picking roofs. See what this is about. Check this out. It's Oscar. This is Oscar and Dragon, I think. Ooh, fancy. Doom, doom, doom. I don't know. Not sure who it is. They've just gone for similar to what we've done. It's more about getting stuff done rather than looks at this point. Well, we've got more stuff down here. Nearly fell. I wouldn't be putting my boss spawn terminal went that close to my base, but. I don't know, maybe those shields have got heaps of health in there. Okay, I've never tested the theory, but we already know what bosses and gods do to shields, don't we? It's got, 250,000 health? That's not a lot of health. At all, but... Alright. That's cool. Next. That was Pick and Riths. What else we got here? LZ purple in blah blah blah. Spoil bosses, we don't want the boss one. It's an unnamed one, but let's go and have a look at that. Okay, well, that was not exciting at all. There's nothing here. What else have we got? Awesome picking records. Boss. Exodus House. That's the one I've already been to, but we'll check it out. Check the teleport out. We're riding the dino, what? Yeah, so that's where we've already been. Not at all. Yeah, it's all locked. All locked, sadly. Can't get in. Tell you what, though. Looking good in here. This is... probably the best build we've seen so far. Just like how, looks like it's meant to be there. Good. Excellent job. Okay, let's go. Got a little, just turn over the maps on it. Back to Rag, put myself in a sleeping pod, and then we'll change clusters. And we're going to swap clusters. I'm going to grab a drink. Check where the children are while we load into the other one, so it won't be long. We'll just quickly pop in here. We'll check on the little Obi Raptors. But see if we got any good eggs. Come on, game, mate. Hey, oh, Zit's online. He'll be doing the Obi Raptors. I don't need to worry about it. Just make sure he's doing something productive. He's probably clowning. Help. Oh, man. Made a mistake, Zit. I made a mistake, buddy. How did we get that? That's not good. How did we get the harvesting back? They were all breeding. There was no harvesting with them. Ugh. Anyway, it's alright, we'll fix it now. Is it prime breeding? That's a don't know. It's a prime breeding that's low on stamina. I mean, we can use it if we have to, but I'd rather not. Prime breeding, slow level though. Slow level as well. Slow level, why there's so much slow level junk? Prime harvesting, that's a wyvern. It's probably not gonna breed with an Obi. Oh. How did that happen? Harvesting, the rest of them. Only one breeding and it's low level. Way low on stamina, which is what that one's problem is. Harvesting. That's breeding, but again, it's low. Quick swap over of clusters. Here's Zeke. He'll sort that out. We'll get rid of that Apache token. Add that to the collection. Quick swap over there. Exit. Change clusters. Alright. I'll just be 2 minutes, guys, while we do this. And grab a quick drink, and I'll swap to Koalas. Put this video on, please.
About a month ago now, and I'm doing a competition on Koalas. Doing a quick fly around and everybody's built. It's a very nice building. I'm doing coming up next month. So let's have a quick look. It's my ears are steam bucket. So, breeding facility there. Steam bucket is a very new addition to the service. So I'm just so we can have a play with some of the very interesting stuff here. This is just a steampunk and combination of the custom sports and a few of the other mods. So yeah, some yeah, nice punk stuff to build with. This is been on this a long time. Members of the server, very, very good for us. A long time. One of the nicest ones. He does love his bathrooms. Yes, this is what I'm going to build. Worth checking out into the mod stuff. Right, just a question of a couple of others. Some of them close together and others will that's actually take a break for unless you're not going to fire around the whole map. They do it just to do the building competition. We've got a great bunch of guys and a couple of partners as well, you imagine. I love the mouse kicks and kicks to power seed. Just let it all rent in. It's quite a bit of fuel, but it's actually on top of it. It's part of it, so very hard to build. And with the rest of the steam building, so that's 3 eggs. No. Dining room, flags, all part of one of the mods. Keeping their sheep inside, maybe in New Zealand. Australia and New Zealanders will get that. Nice big castle. But for this guy, just doing the sort of beginning of the month for the build, so did a very big job in a short space of time. Very nice to very much build the tree. Great spot. Beehives. That's half of it, isn't it? That's half of it. That's half of it. Make actually really good light. They illuminate multiple floors below them, but they're very, very good lighting. This is actually part of the steampunk mod as well. It's the trike power, or type power, as they call it. Basically, a little trike goes on there, and you provide almost like tech power, as they call it. So that's another one of their builds. So that was both the same side. Start down here.
combination of quite a few different mods, steampunk, and this is also one of the eco stable mods. This is mostly all steampunk, beautiful stuff. Beautiful greenhouse, so it's a fully functional greenhouse with all the different plants and stuff for the market. We are back. We're now on Cabalas Live, not on the video. Grab a... We got a wyvern? Yeah, I got a wyvern. We'll be right. Do-do-do. Again. Yeah, we walk away too, that's the plan. So this is our start of our humble abode for the building comp. So we haven't spent a lot of time here yet, but we've got to start. We've got a shell at least. Nothing else. There's nothing up, nothing really inside. We've got a shell, so. And a plan. Alright, let's look around, I think. We'll have a fly around. There are some bases on teleports. We'll do Cabalas first, then we'll duck to Forge or Crystal. There's some on Rag. Typical Cabalas weather, can't see anything anyway. We'll go by maps that have been rendered probably, but... Here we go. I don't even know, I haven't even seen this base before. Whoa, this is still good. This is a new one. This wasn't here when I was here last. Got a good start, it's sort of, yeah. Got a shell happening. Something on top of, actually might be something on top of this hill thing here. It's hard to see, there is a hill there, I promise. Just can't see it at the moment. It's somewhere this way. I think. Maybe that way. Yeah, I think there was a base up on top of this hill. I know there's a couple over back over towards the volcano. Cold apparently, I probably should put clothes on, but I don't think it'll kill me, right? That's why it's really slow. Guys, this is our PvE cluster of 8. Cabalas being... No base, that's a super cool gear. I like that. There was a base here. Maybe Bernie moved. Bernie had a base here, but maybe the Giga's convinced her that... Whoa. Well, we might have to come back and tame them later. If we tame both of those... I like the colours in that one. I'm not even sure I have the stuff to tame Giga's yet, but... Anyway, we're not here to look at Giga's, are we? There was a base there, but maybe they decided to move because of all the Giga spawns. Okay. There was some bases down along the edge of this volcanic area. I'll try and remember their exact positionings. Fairly certain it's this way. Hang on, I see something up here. Oh no, that's... I don't know what that is. Some sort of weird render thing. side, but. Let's see what teleports we've got to start. I know, how good is this map? Veg Portal, blah, blah, blah. Hunters and Collectors, we'll go there. Hunters and Collectors came third, I think. In our last building comp. I don't know how much building they've been doing. Not much, but it's more breeding, I'd say. A lot of breeding. Gotchas, nice wyvern. I know they just finished doing boss fights and stuff, so. Yeah, right. Well, they haven't done any real breeding yet. I'm sure they will. Check out this one. Whoa. Uh-oh. Hello? How did that happen? Need something to shoot across the... Come on, hit something. There we go. We're up. Wow. Full steampunk base. Hello! Lovely base you have here. This was not the base that we were planning on visiting. They have another base on Forgeor. This is beautiful. This is beautiful. Wow. This is cool. Going up? Not gonna let me up. Or down. Down, maybe. No. There's a down, apparently. We can't get down there, though. Ooh, we're down. Oh, check it out. Wowzers. There's been a lot of work going into some of these builds already. A lot of work. Wow. I might just live here from now on, chat. I think this is amazing. Jeepers. This is freaking awesome, guys. This is a build. How good is the steampunk stuff? Love it. Very talented builder, Z. Very talented builder. Got some competitions in. I know, steampunk as well. Let's see what else we're checking out. Quickly, before I shut the door on us. Oh, we're going down. Hang on, I'll just camera up a bit for you guys so you can see. Oh, they got the full steampunk, the big thing to make the airship and stuff. Oh, they've already got the balloon. And that, what were these things called? So, wow, they have been amazingly busy. Breeding going on. Okay, water breeding. Let's check out the water breeding. Wowzers. Just did not even know that this was here. And actually I recall Bernie saying that it still was a build. This is just amazing. Hot waters, we got big troubles. That they build well above our level. We're gonna have to up our game, mate. Gonna have to up our game. It's much better with a tour, right? Much better having a tour guide. Like, you can get to see all the ins and outs of the base. Like, that would be ideal. Yeah, sorry. Alright, just 2 seconds. We'll just duck back to our little base. I think that's our base. Apparently the kids left the key behind. I need to let them in. I'll be right back. Oh, sorry about that, guys. Kids were not actually locked outside. Cracking left his kid door key, but Sophie had it, so we're all good there. Alright, so there is, or was, I'm pretty sure, another base down here somewhere. That was impressive, though. I mean, that's like next level. We've got some work to do, Zit. I'll tell you what, you're going to have to come up with something pretty fancy this time. Bernie, I don't know whether you're there, but the bar has been risen. So yeah, lots of work to be done. Lots of work to be done. That is for certain. Standout leader so far, definitely. Yeah, I'm sure that there was a base along this line here somewhere. They had wyverns and all sorts of stuff there. Knocked the boss down. That was beautiful. I loved all the chibi displays. Oh, there's my mate. I love these guys. Psychos, if you hurt them. Oh, Zitasaur. Come on now. You release rats in your own base. Or rock drakes, at least. And wyvern gods. That was a solid plan. That'd be good text ego if anyone wants a text ego. Now where was that? I'm sure it was along here somewhere, but I don't know. Maybe they moved too. People do move, they pick all this stuff up and just, you know, go somewhere else. So, I guess now we... Actually, I think, from memory, someone told me that there is a base in the cave that... Well, that's... We've really got to spend more time over on these servers. Look, check out that thing. These Evo creatures are awesome. Really have to spend some more time over on this PvE cluster. There's some beautiful creatures here. Haven't even seen my favourite yet. I wonder where would they spawn on this map? I don't even know. The elephants are my favourite still. They're still my favourite animal in all of Ark. The Rexes. Sweet Chili has a nice base on that lake back this way. Go through this one, this lake. I'm gonna need all the help I can get because I haven't spent enough time over here. As you guys know, I've been Omega addicted. Oh, here we go. So yeah, the more help. Oh wow, See, look how busy you guys have been. This is impressive. I love it. I love it. I love it. Oh. Wowzers. I can land here, right? Yeah. Well, that's an awesome Magnosaur. Love the colour. They're also one of my favourites. This is the beginning of the new era. It really is. Yeah. Yeah, thank you guys so much for coming, hanging out, and creating with us. This is really awesome. Love it. Love having everybody on here. And servers have been getting busier and busier with some really awesome people, which is great. Haven't got too many idiots, which is impressive. Just get that on a lot of servers. So they got this here, and then they've got steampunk stuff up there. Let's go look at the steampunk stuff. Okay, so they use the steampunk behemoth gate, which is a beautiful gate. It's actually really impressive. So this is Vixen's base, okay. So this is not, this is not Sweet Chili's place that you're talking about? This is a different one again. Oh, her tribe, mate, my bad, sorry. Alright, I'm not going to look, I can't go in, but I'm just going to have a little, it's not going to let me anyway. That's right, we'll fly on the wyvern and have a look. So the, when we do the, wow, this is super impressive again, oh my god. When we do the actual proper, competition, we'll get everybody to unlock their stuff, and hopefully if they can, be obviously time zones can be a bit difficult, but be on just to like give us a bit of a guided tour around, because it does make it a lot easier. Even if we narrow it down to like the top 5 or 10 or something, and then they can give us a quick tour if they're available in the time window that's going to work for everybody. But wow, busy, everybody's been busy. I think there was a that's that little thing here. I think someone built in the cave that I built in up here in the redwoods, the other drop down to the waterfall bit. Not sure who that was, but I heard that there was a build up there. Ah, oh, they left. Okay, all right, yeah, cool. I won't bother flying up there if they left. That's fine. I know Cabalas has been very busy at overnight, like our time. It is an awesome cave. Yeah, I had a lot of fun building in that one. It's a real shame you can't build on those properly, because they would make for some great bases. But you can put stuff there, but you can't really make a proper base out of it, unfortunately. That'd be cool to be able to cross those over. Just for something different. There's a Giga spawn underneath there. Found that out the hard way. Oh, there's a shiny pumpkin Carno. Anybody wants a Carno? So Gofrid, have you got a build on Cabalas or any of the maps? I'm gonna do Fjordor next. Right, all these different names. Oh, here's my favorite creature. These are the elements, I love these guys. These ones. Yeah, so your place on Fjordor we gotta go and have a look at, right? I love taming them properly too. I mean, I'm sure you can immersive tame them, but doing it with beer is awesome. I mean, It's a good way to get your butt kicked, but it's awesome. They've been probably my favorite team since they came out. And FYI, just so everybody knows, these guys here, will be available for ASA on release. Confirmed by the developer, they have already got the stuff worked on. The acro won't be in though. The acro is not finished. So we will have some mods potentially on release day, assuming that our genius IT guys can come up with some form of server management software. That will be a work in progress after release because we won't get an option beforehand. So once ASA is out, we will spin up a server and go modded as much as we possibly can, but it's going to be limited, and look, it's probably going to crash 3 times a day, but we'll work on that as we go. So, but the PvE and the Amiga and everything will stay. That's, none of that's changing. We'll keep, yeah, normal arc going. Hang on, we got something here. What have we got here? Just a start. All right. I like it. So yeah, I was on their Haven Space, Australia. Another friend. Okay. Cool. More the merrier. This is 3. Yeah. Okay. So. Yep. So start. Oh yeah. Start at Steampunk Foundations. All right. No, tell them to build. Just tell them to build awesome. The more the merrier, the better. I love a good build. I get inspired when I see builds like that one. That was just beautiful. Blown away by your build over there. That's, yeah. And the tour is, like, you being there made it so much better because I could actually, well, number one, I could actually get in, but I could actually get to see the whole thing properly. So this is our very humble little abode, but we have literally nothing. It's like the shell. We have done nothing. We've got stairs and a big room of nothing. Oh, we got it. We have a gotcha. There we go. We haven't got nothing. We have a gotcha. But we'll do some decorations at some point. Okay, we'll go to Fjordor. Do we have a base on Fjordor? Probably, but I might just make a couple of foundations, a couple of these for the other maps, just in case stuff goes wrong. Knock it down, might as well knock it down. That's it. It's not even comparison, we'll just start again. Them and some of them. It'd be probably, that one actually be pretty easy to knock down. Pull a couple of foundations and the whole thing tumbled down. He's definitely skipped leg day. So Kraken is my son. So whenever we start a new character, we give each other a random number between 1 and 20, and you have to press the random generate button, and that's your character. It doesn't matter what you get, you have to use that. That's a way we've been playing for years. And look at him, he's pretty OP. So Kraken turned out to be some giant, I think, this time. Where is he? Let's have a look. That's a bit out of cell. He doesn't look that big there, but he's quite large. So yeah, we have random generation numbers every single time, just to mix it up. 3 beds, 3 teleporters, 3 things. Perfect. All right, let's go to We'll go to Fjordor. That way we can check out. I don't know. I'm sure that's the same high energon that's been there the other, when I was here the other day. I'm supposed to have a dino wipe every night. I'll have to check on that. Fjordor. Join. Now we do actually have a base on Fjordor. Well, base. A landing pad. We did actually start on Fjordor this fight briefly, but after probably about 15 hours, we got bored and changed to Cabalas. Not that there's anything wrong with Fjordor, but it's not Cabalas. I didn't even spawn the bed on anything. But... Let's see. Here we go. Alright, so your public, your teleport should be on public, so we'll, here we go. We'll start here. Boom. So this is build number two. We haven't even started, we even haven't even got quarter way through build one, and you're already on build two. Oh, you can't put that out here, you idiot. What are you doing? See, location, location, location. Look at the view. Bridge. So this is this the one of these coffee pots or something's the you can turn into a tech generator, right? Is that what you? Yeah, right. That's, so, so that powers like the whole base. That's awesome. The these plants are good, aren't they? It is a big range. Okay, that's cool. Yeah, I haven't we just threw a tech generator down because yeah, habits, I guess. But we'll have to have a play with it. The pot plants are good, eh? I mean, obviously, it's great to get black pearls and all that junk, but they just look really good, like with the way all the different crops come up. But the rare mushrooms and flowers and the, yeah, crystals and stuff. It's made a big difference. Oh, what is that one? Oh, the CK point. So you pick beautiful spots to build. I really, really love both your locations. I've always been a fan of the build of building in a place that's got good views. I just think it's important. Run it. 12 foundations way up here. You can get an aerial view. It's just a small outpost though. Bigger than most people's bases. That is beautiful. Wow. Just give you somewhere to land, I suppose, when you come over to Fjordor. Just a cliff platform, yeah, beautiful. Make more baits and stuff, okay, yep. It's a good map, I do enjoy Fjordor. Like, it's got all the, like, it's got all the good dinos. It's not as good as Cabalas, clearly. The map's not as good. Cabalas has got more, and Cabalas has every single dino that you could possibly want. Except for Striders, but I mean, you can live without Striders. And Fjordor doesn't have Striders either. Or Reapers. Does Fjordor have Reapers? No, it doesn't. Whereas Cabalas has got Reapers, if you're willing to swim down there. And Desmoduses, yes. Is there Desmoduses on Cabalas? I don't think there is. Mm. Interesting. Only on Fjordor. Surprised. I thought they would have added that. Because they added the Andrew Sarkis and the Fjordor. Whenever that was. 6 months ago, probably. I wonder if Cabalus will go onto Ascended. We'll have to have a look. I'll shoot their... Is that red thing there? I'll shoot their message on their Discord and see whether what their plan is. I would imagine it would. I think probably some of the maps... what was that one? Svedihaim, whatever it was that we did early on. I have a feeling that that guy... Because he's a sponsored guy as well, so he probably would have access to the dev kit straight away. That was a good island. That was a good island, yeah. So, we might have access to maps reasonably soon. Because, you know, I mean, it'll be fun checking out the island in, you know, better graphics and whatever other features they offer. But... let's face it, we've all spent far too much time on the island. Sentimental value, it's great, but that's about it. Alright, what else have we got on Fjordor? Anybody know? Let's have a look what teleports we've got. Obi-Wan. That's us. Asmodus, Helm's Deep. Soul. Should we try that? Sure. It's the worst that could happen. Base, but not something just a whoa, calm down, mate, calm down. Just a little starter house.
How long since they've been on? Oh, yeah, they're all pretty recent.
Not can't fly here. I do like this realm. Just have a quick look at the Drake. I'll have a quick look, see what else, see if there's anything here. Yeah, Cabalus, yeah. And everybody's main base should be on Cabalus. Best map. Bernie, what, Topwitch, what happened to your Cabalus base on top of the hill there? Like in the Giga spawns. By the way, PS, if anyone's looking for Eco Gigas, there was two awesome Eco Gigas on top of the hill there. A low level one, but they had really good colours. Yeah, I know. Too many Gigas, too many Karchas. I did mention that to you, but I'm pleased to see you've moved without getting your base totally destroyed. It's a nice spot, but it's just too many gigas. Doesn't look like there's too many bases here. Let's teleport back to base. We'll go and do Crystal next. OP1. Go and have a look at Bernie's place on Crystal and Ferret's if it's unlocked. I don't know whether it's unlocked. He'll be at work presently. Not even sure if he's public teleport. You're up. I don't think I've been to Crystal yet, so I'll probably have to put a bed and stuff down anyway when I get there. So, you're home earlier than I was expecting, so. Thank you again, Gertrude, for the for the run through the base, really appreciate it. Your Cabalus build is mind-blowingly beautiful. Love the chibi room. That was awesome. I could just live in that room. Hey, we have been here. Not sure what for, but we've been here apparently. Huh. Good spot. check that out. Too. Shall we check yours out here as well? Or is that same thing, just a little... I mean, this is our forward operating base. This is yours. We have three foundations and two beds. You have a beautiful build. Of course. I'm gonna have to up my game. We're like amateur hour. You must just be embarrassed walking around seeing these places. This is beautiful as well. Wow. Another beautiful one. That's a great. Which roof is that? Atlas. Oh yeah. Atlas. Okay. That's a really nice roof. It is small, but it is beautiful. It's that hum, where are we? Oh, that's that hum from that thing over there, yeah. Dragon Sworn Lodge. Sure, we'll go there. I'm not sure what burning space is even called. This could be it. Dodo Killers. Look at a sign. What does this say? Home of Tech Giggers. This is definitely Bernie's place because she is breeding Tech Giggers. Oh, it's unlocked. That's nice. Tech Giggers came from... what map was that? It was a weird map. It's one of the last ones we ran on the event server before we decided to wipe and change everything up. The no-fly one, yeah. Nice glass. There's some good stuff in that RR, isn't there? Also from Kraken, yeah. I almost put Kraken on there as well. It seems like a lot of servers ran it, and so I decided to go for the eco one, just to mix it up a little bit. It was actually from one of the modded maps, and when we wiped, we created a safe server. So if anyone wanted to keep dinosaurs and their character, they could move temporarily over there and keep their stuff, so that that way you didn't want to lose it and start again. You didn't have to. Tech Giga breeding facility. All right, let's see if can we get in here. Well, it's not a breeding facility at the moment, apparently. I know they were. They were only like low levels, I think, like level ones and fives and stuff like that just spawned in randomly on the map in one spot. It was an okay map, for a no-fly map, it was a little bit too vertical. But there was a lot of straight up downs, and there was a lot of maps that you would not have been able to get to without a flyer. Once you had a rock break, I guess you could do it. Get away from me. It's a cool building for Brendan Giggers in, right? The Giggers must be really close to the ceiling in here. Pretty tall. Oh, here's Bernie. She's in. Let's have a, can we have a look at your, can we have a look at your tech Giggers, Bernie? Whoa. Okay, so we're capped out in melee. 254. Beautiful. That is a cool giga. Yeah, that's a long way. 254 from like a level 1 giga, which had like 1 point in melee. Oh, she's already done health as well, so she just hasn't combined them yet. Wow. Excuse me, guys. I'm still trying to get over this cold. Holy moly. Some very impressive tech he is. I mean, you know, I guess you're gonna have to. I guess you have to do stamina, right? Food doesn't matter, weight doesn't matter. But you're gonna have to do stamina because you can't really have no points in stamina. Excuse me. Oh, stamina's done too. Wow. All right, so there, stamina's done as well. She's been busy. They're gonna be amazing. 254 points of stamina. Scary thing is, that literally gave it from 400 stamina to 450. Jeepers. And weight as well. Yeah, holy hell. Suddenly I was awake enough to leave my bed. Bleary-eyed, I stretch and yawn. We get murdered here, chat, by these giggers. I know I've done it all before. I now ruined it for a giggers. That is impressive. From a level 1 Kiga, you have all 4 stats capped out. That is quite amazing. That is some serious breeding. And still have time to build a beautiful base to go with it. I don't think I've ever owned a tech giga. I mean, I've had a tech giga skin on my giga, but I don't think I've actually ever had a tech giga. Bernie's got one more to throw out by looks. Here we go. Okay, so that's the original. That's the OG Mr. Giga. Level 1 tech giga. No points in anything. Oh, wow. Okay. So, health was good. That was definitely worth doing. A lot of health, and obviously melee. from a level, that is dedication, Bernie, from a level one giga all the way to 255 for each of them. Job well done. That's unbelievable. Have you even tried them yet? Wow. You know, I think you should do combine them all, and then we'll have to have like a special event over on that's mum. Have to have a special event, take them over to Extinction and do some purple drops or red drops or something. Just to, you know, warm them up. They're gonna have a lot of power. Alright, well I'm down for that. You let me know when you're ready and I'll organise an event and we'll go and we'll just pile in on them on and we'll do some purple drops and stuff on Extinction. Just to level them all up, because they'll get stacks of levels doing that. And we get to like test them out properly, right? They're beautiful, Bernie. Amazing. Thank you for showing off your giggers. Alright, we... Someone's done all the artifacts. Awesome. We did so. He mustn't have his teleport on public. Bernie, do you know where Barrett is at all? Just roughly, I can fly there. These gates are the Atlas one, I think. Yeah, Atlas Woodgate. I love the Atlas mod. There's so many there's so many good options. They're just beautiful. It's probably got about 58 different, you know, I know the stone ones we use, there's like so many different versions of them. Is that the same one? Pretty much. Ooh. Wow. All right. Onward we go. Actually, you can probably leave from here. Lots of variations. Shall we go to... We'll go to Valgera. I don't think anyone's been playing Extinction. There's a couple on Lost. We'll go to Valgera. I know there's definitely one base on Valgera. Pretty sure that... I'm pretty sure that the teleport's on public. She hasn't played for a while, so... I don't know what the base is like, exactly. Excuse me. We'll go and have a quick little look. Look at that. We've got bases everywhere. Well, bases. Foundation and a bed. Go and check it out. This will be impressive on its own, I'm sure. Oh, okay. Look, you're gonna have to do some work over here, Gertrude. Look, this is just not at your level. You can't just have like this little bunkhouse. How good are the tree houses, though? I kept this mod on. We have had this mod for ages. We kept this mod on because they were, I mean, number one, they're really good starter homes. But this is the one that's got the trailers in it as well, where you can drag things around and like farm stuff. Behind like the horse and the stuff like that. And there's a Shinehorn one as well, which was my favorite, honestly. Alpha's Cave, that's where we go. When I was going through the mod list, I was like, oh, do I get rid of it? I'm like, nah, they make such good like starter bases. You can just throw them down and you've got a, you know, you've got a nice safe place to sleep in. Right, I don't think I'll have access, to this one. Great starter homes, yeah, just a great starter home. So, This is Alpha's place, but she hasn't been on for ages. It is a lot. We'll have a quick little look. Oh, yeah. It's good. Everything's unlocked. That's kind of nice. Another nice build, isn't it? That one's locked. That must be the special room. That's where all the good stuff's hidden. Oh, jeez. She's trying to trap us in here. Lets you up, doesn't let you down. Oh, that's a sneaky trick. It's okay, we have the technology. Oh, actually, boo. Yeah, we're going higher again, maybe. No, it's probably another level up. Yeah, so she's done a bit of building. She's got like a swimming pool. That's not bad, that's cool. What a good idea. You have a nice little outdoor entertaining area, got a pool, a little jacuzzi. She's got a lot of, I know she's done a lot of breeding. She's quite into her breeding apparently. So this is also still breeding stuff. Welcome to the breeding house. Oh, that's Oh, that's the, like the dedicated, yeah, that's the dedicated storage for the RR version of it. Yep, I'm with it. That stores eggs, that's neat. Okay. A little other. Duchess. Alright, so. Okay, I saw Soul had a base here too, right? Same deal though, right? I'm guessing it's just like a little starter base. Yep. Oh, they're like just on the hill from us. They're way up the back. Yeah, okay, we're down there. Nice. All right, let's go and see. Aussie Dan Dan has something on the Island of Lost. Actually, let's go to Rag. We go to Rag first. Go and check out what's on Rag. We have nothing here. We haven't been to Rag yet. We're on Rag on Amiga, so that would make sense. It's kind of annoying how you gotta name the thing I was on. Oops, someone else got a starter shack here. Who's this? Who this? Gorex. Yep, no clue. That's alright, we'll run up a little bit. See what teleports are alive here, eh? We chilling. Excuse me, if you don't mind. Whoa, you apparently do mind. Now you're going to get yourself dead. That was not required. The old lighthouse. Yep. I like it. Well, that is good. So we live underneath this on Amiga. I'm nearly dead. All right. Let's see what else is here. Autumn's Rock. Let's check that out. Has to be less violent than a lot else. Sounds peaceful. All right. Oh yeah, just joint. Yep. Howard by the wind turbine, I guess. Okay. Has anyone used wind turbines in so long? No one ever uses them anymore. Right, next one up is, I believe, we are going to your place again. Another treehouse. Depends how much you like rag, right? Treehouse for rag. Oh no, we've got stuff here. Oh yeah. Good choice. There's some not quite nice little islands and ruins and stuff out here, which is kind of fun to build around, I reckon. Not sure which island it is, but... you just started this one today? Okay, yeah, right. Yeah, good. I've sort of looked at a couple of these islands and thought maybe pretty fun to rebuild around some of these ruins just for something different. Yeah, safe, that's right. Yeah, nice safe island, and you know, like, you're not you're a long way from the snow and stuff, but it teleports, it doesn't really matter where you are. Secret weapon here, yeah, but yeah, and this was right, like, this, like, there was a lot of metal and like resources were quite easy to get without having to go too far, which is what I liked about it. Plus safe and yeah, nice little location, easy bit of, you know, water breeding, straight in the water, bang, done. Well, I mean, fences clearly. So yeah, I do love the paleo stuff though. I really like the colouring. They look actually even better now that I've added the event, so you get a bit of colour. I just thought I'd drop that when we had the servers drop the other day for the update. I thought, well, now's as good of a time as any, because I've got to actually stop the server to put that on now. I can't just do it when it's live, so... I forgot to do Cabalus and Crystal. No colours on Cabalus or Crystal yet, but next time they're offline, I'll add an event of some description. Just go back to the way we used to always have the colours. Just kept the taming and the breeding, you know, a bit more interesting. Right, what else have we got? We got anything else in here? Crystal Cave. That's a sweet chili already. No, it looks like all the teleports. That looks like all the teleports. Is there any... I don't think I know of anything else here. Alright, let's go to Lost. Let's get Lost on Lost. This is actually the map that the servers all started on. Way back. Hosted from my PC, sitting right here, on a non-dedicated server. I think there was three or four of us playing, and then, yeah, that increased to the point where we are at where we're at.
Yeah,
This is our always base starting spot on Lost Island. It's a safe little island on the. It's actually a hard spawn, right top of the map. But it's a safe little island, and you got silica pearls right there. Nice and easy to get, and then metal up on the hill right. That ridge line there, I think. So you can easily get, plus there's obviously closer stuff as well, but like there's masses, like there's so much. Actually, we're gonna go that way anyway, so. I mean, if you know Lost Island, you would know that the metal's there, I'm sure. They're easy to get metal and easy to get pearls, so you can pump out the electronics pretty quick. Get yourself up and running. But yeah, basically all of this here is metal and crystal and obsidian and just small amounts of nodes. There's all crystal through there, obsidian there. And it's just metal everywhere the whole way through here. It's insane. And that mountain, that there, that's like about 35 to 45,000 metal on that hill with the magma saw, like a good magma saw. Now, Dan is on here somewhere. Which side of the mountain was he? I think he's on the evil side. I believe. You know, I've never built in this ice cave. Oh, someone has. Aha, soul. Yeah, I reckon that'd be a really fun build. It'd be tricky. But it'd be a fun one. I've always looked at it and thought, oh, we should do that one, but I've never done it. We've done the castle in the middle a couple of times. Yeah, I used to always come here and get my Rexes. This is where I used to get my Rexes for breeding and stuff for the bosses. And I think Dan. Ozzy of the Dan should be right in front of me. There he is. He's got his little house going on here. Saw him building here the other day on stream. Oh, he's got a bug. Where did he get his bug from? Zoolander. Comes up with some crazy names, young Dan. Another baby. Right. The original. I guess it was another baby. This must be stuff he kept, right? I can board the passenger seat even though I'm not. Huh? Even though we're not even alliance up, that's odd. Alright, so he's got a start. It's a work in progress. Right, I might have to show Dan that some of the mods. I mean, maybe he wants to just build out of the normal S Plus stuff, which is cool. But I think he'd have a lot of fun playing with some of the mods. Maybe he doesn't know where to look for him or something. Maybe next time one sees him streaming Ark, obviously. We'll have to show him how to get to the Atlas and the CKF and stuff, so that he can have some more building options. Because I didn't even. That looks like where he's got his building tables. Whoa. Man. He's got RR stuff. Oh, he's got Dwarven now. But he hasn't got any of the Atlas ones. Unless they're out here somewhere. Weapons Plus, Normal Smithy. No, so. We'll have to remember to try and tell him to make the other crafting benches. Alright, it's actually safer here than I thought it would be. I thought it would be mildly aggressive here, but it's actually mostly just parasaurs and stuff. Whew. Right, my throat's killing me, guys. Just give me five. I'm just gonna grab a quick drink. I'll start that other movie thing back up again. I'll be right back. It will not be long.
Another one of these bad ones. Just a spectacular build. Really, really impressive. Love that. Love greenhouse. Outdoor entertaining area. It's probably more cover, but it is also a fully functional greenhouse. This is stable. Just see if we can, maybe she forgot to lock the back door and I can sneak in. Well, I've got a check. Whoa! Apparently I can't floss the mic up, same on me. We can sneak in, so. This is, yeah, long time member of the service. She's well over a year now. Lovely lady, and she's. The building has come a long, long way. Her arc has come a long, long way. It's gone from a 4x4 box, being too scared to come out of it, to building stuff like this in no time at all. Yeah, so she's got some nice, really nice builds and stuff. We're going to go back and have a little look in there. The kitchen there. Oh, that's a nice use of the bench. Dining room. Steampunk windows, carpet, kitchen boards. Actually, all blends together really well. Next. Doubly impressive when you see what they got done in such a short space of time. It's quite amazing actually what they've done. A bit of hard work and grind this out in 2 weeks. It's quite impressive. They actually joined the server earlier, but they're playing around on the island, having a great time. Such a short amount of time, so yeah, great effort on their behalf. Some really nice features. That I've got a checkerboard hall, yeah, awesome. Looking down into the water, the play school, you know, windows. So that'll mean something to some of you, but some of you may be too young to understand what play school actually is. So again, another lovely castle build. Well decorated. They did all this in a couple of weeks, so they haven't quite finished. It's definitely not sure frame time.
they have done a wonderful job. Full stop, but like 2 weeks of work. Octavia and family for a wonderful, second base for the one and the third base for the three. We'll head over to the far west coast and have a little gander at that one. We'll go north. We'll go north first. Check out that place there. Talking about the time and technology, we've now got more than a map. So we're going to do a little cave build. Go up there. Yeah, very nice, big open cave. More fodder up there. This is all dwarven mod, pretty much. Shoppy stuff. Got what's it called? Bathroom. Yeah, the bathroom. Hey, it's my cave. Yes, I have a Shine Horn addiction. I love them. What can I say?
Dragon texture. Yeah, nice. Nice little one. Yeah, beautiful.
What's that? Go back to Ark. Where even am I? Oh, I'm at Dan's place still. Right. We're back. Alright, we got anything else on this map? In the desert. I like it. Something a bit different. Well, sneaky, let's say Kodri had like the cave. Is that what that's about? Kodri's a big fan. It's a good fun cave, that one. We've got some good stuff out of that cave over the time. Oh, it's cold as kicking me. Anyway, we're all good. I'm a lot better than I was. I only shared it with the rest of my family, so that's, you know, sharing is caring. Not probably so much with this, but. Okay. I love this map. This is so beautiful. Weather effects. So I'm really looking forward to seeing. All these new maps in UE5. It should be amazing what they can do. Hopefully they do a good job. Aside from graphically, also the weather effects that, you know, you can actually have snow falling on the ground. Probably not the desert, but you can have snow falling on the ground and actually building up. So that should be quite interesting to see what they do with that. I know, the weather effects on Scorched are pretty impressive, so they hopefully continue that same line with the rest of the maps would be awesome. It's beautiful though. That beautiful glowing red of the sunset. All right. Well, that's probably enough for our tour of the Ark so far builds that we know of. I know that there are a lot more that I don't know about yet, but that's okay. Some people want to keep stuff close to their chest. And Gen 2! Thank you. Haven't done Gen 2. We've got to go check out that one. We'll have to go check out Doxa's base. Yeah. I'm just going to plug in a bit more RAM, apparently, from what I've heard, before we load into Doxa's base. Did Gen 2, so it's right down south, Bernie, right? Is that the story? Gen 2 is the hidden gem. It is, yeah, I have not laid eyes in Doxa's base. This will be interesting. Is she back yet? Well, she's been in Discord a bit, but I haven't seen her back, so. I haven't actually seen her online, is what I'm getting at. Why am I getting this now? Oh, new in. Yeah, that's right. It's a fresh install. That's
really got you good. No worries. Just hang in there for a second.
In the vein here since I did the upgrade, so.
Your armor kept you mostly in one piece. So, quick update. This isn't a simulation. We're really on a ginormous spaceship. And the ship's being taken over by.
Now what are you two little gnats?
Yeah, this is, I've got to watch it. Sorry, guys.
This is to be mine.
Okay, time to get away from all these tentacles and prying eyes. This might feel a bit weird.
Oh, that wasn't that bad. It's fairly short. That was the Gen 1 one that's really long, isn't it?
Alrighty then. So.
Yeah. Be quiet.
I've got some good news and some.
Alright, so. Right down south.
I'm just going to use this.
Right down south, eh? Can you be quiet? Stop talking. Oh, okay, thanks. That makes way easier.
Interface with the ship's various subsystems. Through a virtualized representation of those
interfaces. Lots of bases over here too. We'll start with Doxa's and then I'll hit the others. See what they're like.
If we're able to do that to enough subsystems, then we might weaken them enough to.
Can you stop talking?
Well,
cool, that's all.
On the ship's main bridge. Yeah. It's a one shot. But if anyone can pull it off, it's you, Simon. Well, let's get to it then, shall we?
Here. Let's get a little feel for what's going on here. Oops, got a space whale. Awesome. Leaving it. She's got the skip out now. Damn. Doctor's been busy too. It's not that big a base. What are you guys talking about? Bernie, your place last time on Gen 2 is way bigger than this, right? That big glass mansion you had, that was huge. Steampunk. Nice base, yeah. Happy Gal, yeah. Well, yeah, I'll probably get lost. That's okay. Thankfully, we can teleport out. How much you got this? How are the stairs so skinny? They wedged into something. Huh? Is there skinny stairs or something? Yeah, I know. Docs likes me, so I don't pick on it. Miranda. Love the swimming pool down there. She has been busy, hasn't she? She's put it right into the wall there. Yeah, nice. Little putty cat. That was off. We didn't have one. Jeepers. Termists, armors, resources, saddle. I bet they're all full too. Such a hoarder. She loves collecting stuff. Oh, hello. Hello, Shinehorn. I need to put them out here. A Shinehorn gift for the stream. One of the ones that they're like bouncing up and down when you level them up. Does anyone know how to do that? I think I looped around, right? We go up here. This is a different section to where we were before, right? I think. Yeah, it is. Oh, there's two different stair widths. Okay. Oh, so that was just a different way up. Okay. The sound of a Shinehorn and a chainsaw. Whoa, 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 see, come on now. We don't do violence. When it comes to Shinehorns. Is anyone in Discord or come on? And I'm not, I know that. What the heck is that? Is there some sort of trampoline thing I don't know about? What's this? What's going on? Doing? We jump off the jumping board. Gotta swim. The pool looks awesome. It's really well lit. I like that. Cool. This is beautiful. She's done a really good job, hasn't she? It's nowhere near as big as I was thinking it was going to be. The way you guys were going on, it was like this, you know, colossal thing that takes 120 years to load in. Well, it's big, but it's not crazy. Probably take a bit to load in by the time, like when she decorates all inside. But another beautiful base. Wow. Look up. Hang on. Look, I don't know where I was supposed to look up. Where am I supposed to look up? Oh, up. Is there more up there? Really? Like all the way up there? Okay, so this is like a work in progress. More to come up here, obviously. Okay. Oh, she got a turtle. With a carcanos. The waterfall actually waters the cripples. It's a good location, this too. I was going to build here last time, I think. We actually put a few foundations down and stuff. Which is obviously got plans to do something over here as well. I don't think it's spawn up there anyway. Let's see what that. Let's check out the other ones. Check out Chili's. Let's see what she's got going on here.
This is a Terran Federation starship, and it's been searching for a habitable world for generations. Just imagine how much
effort it's just one in the light.
To gather all of this up and shoot it off into space.
Space bridge, docks. They are all friends go these ones. Chili and what was the other one? INA. Ooh, on the evil side. Okay, I like it. This is probably the prettiest side, honestly. It's just evil. Although, pretty safe where you are. There's nothing really here, is there? Nothing too violent. No plants that are gonna pick me up, are they? They always get me, those suckers. Zip build all around those. That was a Christmas house. Where was that? You should put some photos up of that one. That was a cool one. It was like a Christmas tree house. Just so you build all around those snapping plants that kept picking us up and knocking us out. Nice, nice. Ains. Is Ains a friend as well? Go through it or? We're in the space channel. Day. No idea. Yeah, so a lot of really amazing builds already. 2 weeks ago, dude, I think we have to stop playing Amiga for a couple of weeks. And up our game a bit. We've got to put some competition in. You guys in chat or in Discord? Hello, hello. Good chat. You know, no, you.
Hello.
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 Sorry. Yeah, some super impressive builds, yeah? Wow.
Yeah.
I'm amazed. Absolutely blown away. Amazing.
Yep.
Love it. Love it, love it, love it. I'm actually inspired to play PvE. I may actually be off the Amiga server for a little bit now. It actually inspired me to do some building. Not that I think I can build at that level, but I can only try, right?
Yeah, it certainly incentivizes you to stretch your abilities.
It definitely does. So, yes, yeah, Gertrude, thank you very much for the tours and allowing us into your base, and for the inspiration to build again. Because it has been lacking. As much as I love building, I've been lacking the motivation to get stuck into it. So, yeah, you'll be stuck with me on Cabals now, annoying everybody. All right. Is anybody else streaming yet, or? I don't think they are. I can't really talk much anymore. No. My voice is pretty much saying that's enough. I think I'm going live, yeah.
Yep.
All right, thank you so much again, GoTrue, for letting us through your base and for everyone for hanging out. And wow, I'm impressed. And all right, good night. Thank you very much for hanging out. Really appreciate it. Appreciate your time. So I am going to end the stream and maybe go make a cuppa or something, and then I'll be back. So thanks a lot, guys, for watching.
Go take care of you. Okay.
Yes, I'll be back shortly, Gurney.